With everything going on lately, we thought we might see him tonight.
He sure looks determined to get his point across.
Let's see what he has to say.
Yeah, this should be good.
Goldberg, de eso hablaré, porque de eso es de lo que tengo que hablar. Sí, y todo el mundo tiene que estar diciendo, Big Cass venció a Goldberg, antes de que Henry lo hiciera. Estoy seguro que ustedes están pensando eso en su cabeza. Es lo que ustedes hacen, piensan en esas cosas. Pero yo soy más grande de ahí, yo digo, claro que Big Cass puede vencer a Goldberg. Porque Big Cass está en el equipo.
Not
Así
exactly
que, Goldberg, ¿viste lo que hizo Big Cass? No es nada con lo que sucederá en tu pelea contra mí. Así que ya sabes qué pasa cuando te metes con uno de nosotros. Así que te diré esto. Goldberg, ya tuviste el primer toque de lo que significa meterte con nosotros. Ahora te diré esto. Goldberg, he estado analizándote bien, porque sí, yo analizo a las personas a las que me voy a enfrentar. Y es lo que estoy haciendo. Y estuve viendo y dije, ¿qué es Goldberg en realidad? ¿Por qué todos estos bobalicones dicen Goldberg, Goldberg? Y lo he analizado. Tú eres el león, eres el tiger, eres el tiburón en tu ecosistema. Eso eres, Goldberg. Eres la atracción de estas personas. Pero no aquí, Goldberg. Aquí, tú eres ese tiburón. Eres el león. Tú eres...
¡Goldberg, ha salido! ¡Está saliendo Goldberg! Él estaba hablando acerca del tiburón, del león. Goldberg aparece, está bajando, está descendiendo.
He really loves that mic.
He looks very focused right now and ready to make a point.
Let's listen in as he addresses the WWE Universe.
Goldberg. Goldberg.
Yo sé exactamente quién eres tú. Porque tú tienes que analizar quién es Goldberg, porque así de ridículo eres. Pero yo sé exactamente quién eres. Eres el bufón de aquí. Eres el que haces tus chistes y crees que son una verdad. Te paras aquí y dices, Goldberg, y te ríes como si eso fuera a cambiar en algo, que voy a partirte por la mitad, voy a hacerte suple martillo y voy a seguir siendo campeón. Y tú no podrás cambiar eso. Eres la persona que te paras aquí a hablar de lo grandioso que eres, pero Henry, eso no importa. Te subirás al ring con Goldberg.
Yo soy lo único real aquí en este mundo donde estas personas quieren creer en mitos y en cosas como tú. Y se aferran a esas cosas. Porque a la gente no le gusta la realidad. No le gusta ver la verdad. La verdad es, Goldberg, que tú simplemente eres eso. Un nombre a la que las personas se aferran para llenar el vacío que hay en sus vidas. Ese vacío que los hace personas comunes, simples y ridículas, se aferran a cosas como tú.
Así es como tú lo ves. Quizás así es como ellos los ven. No sé por qué me sigan o no, porque jamás he sido el héroe de la historia. Yo solo me subo al ring, hago una lanza y un suple martillo. Y a estas personas les gusta eso. Quizás porque yo jamás he querido más que aplastar a mis oponentes. Y aquí estás tú, hablando de lo real. Te voy a decir la realidad. No pudiste detenerme. Yo te quité el título cuando dijiste que no lo haría. Dices que me ganarás. Yo te digo que no. Y ya.
Esa es la verdad. Y yo te voy a decir la verdad. La verdad por la cual tú no perteneces aquí, porque saliste huyendo de aquí en aquel entonces. Ya perdiste de Big Cass. Ahora, en el pay-per-view, vas a perder de mí. Y eso es lo que sucederá. Y después de que suceda, después de que yo te venzas, te largarás de nuevo, porque sabrás que lo que tú fuiste fuera de este ecosistema, aquí no lo eres, Goldberg. Aquí tú no eres invencible.
Te equivocas, Henry. Big Cass no es el primero en ganarme, así que deja de hablar como si él fuera el primero en mi vida en derrotarme. Big Cass tiene algo. Big Cass es mejor que tú. Big Cass sí pudo competir contra mí, sí pudo resistirme, y sí fue más que un simple Supres martillo y una lanza. Fue más que eso. Big Cass sí me dio una pelea, pero tú, por otra parte, tú no me hiciste ni sudar. Ahora tal vez des una mejor pelea, cosa que dudo, pero tú no eres Big Cass. Eres muy pequeño.
Tienes razón, yo no soy Big Cass. No, no lo soy. Pero ese no es el punto, Goldberg. Lo que te quiero decir es que tú sigues hablando, hablando y hablando y hablando. You are next y todas esas cosas que dices, pero Goldberg. Saldrás huyendo de aquí. Es lo que eres bueno haciéndolo. Vienes, brillas un poco, demuestras de lo que está hecho, pero después de que pierdes, saldrás huyendo. Cuando pierdas de mí, saldrás huyendo. Y no sé qué vas a inventar.
Tú no vas a ganar y es todo. Tú no saldrás huyendo, sino que te sentarás en ese rincón a esperar a que alguien más débil que tú tenga el campeonato. Pero tú a mí no me vas a vencer. Así que da todas las vueltas que quieras, llora lo que te dé la gana. Tú crees que la guerra va a una sola dirección, Henry, y hasta ahora he ido a tu dirección. Pero la verdad es que, si tú quieres una guerra real, yo puedo darte a ti la guerra más grande de tu vida. Y quieres que esto pase de una pelea por el campeonato, una rivalidad, puede pasar. Porque créeme que ya tú fuiste el siguiente. Lo que tú eres ahora es otra cosa.
¿Guerra? Tú ni siquiera representas eso, Goldberg. Tú simplemente eres algo que ponen ahí. El producto para que todos vean, el que llama la atención. Pero tú no eres eso. ¿Guerra real? Tú nunca has tenido eso, Goldberg. Así que deja de hablar estupideces. Tú sabes que eres tú un entremés. Después de Battleground, se acabó Goldberg. Y no digo que no intentarás ganar otro campeonato o algo así, pero ya se acabó. Adiós, Goldberg. Así que, adiós, Goldberg. Adiós, Goldberg. Adiós, Goldberg. Es lo que dirán estas personas, porque sabes que, Goldberg, tú solamente eres eso. Un nombre. Y yo voy a ser campeón de Estados Unidos una vez más. ¿Sabes por qué? Porque lo necesito. Así que, ¿por qué no te vas, Goldberg? Y dices tantas las cosas grandes y dices yo no, que no te ganaré. Hazlo, vete.
Yeah, man, this is going to be a night to remember.
Oh, I'm sure. Well, I'm not sure if we can top that, but we will do our best as we move along with our program. These fans are hoping the next match is as entertaining as the last. Tag team match on the way. It's Team Connor against Team Big E. Stay where you are. The long-awaited tag team battle is coming up next.
This is going to be good.
It'll be the Ascension versus the New Day.
Mark my words, someone's going to pay the price tonight.
The following tag team contest is scheduled for one fall on the way to the ring. At a combined weight of 487 pounds, the WWE Tag Team Champions, Connor and Victor, The Ascension.
As Connor makes his way to the ring, King, please explain to our viewers exactly what TMC is.
Well, TMC stands for Total Maximum Carnage. And not only does Connor subscribe to that philosophy, he executes it to perfection. Man, these teams have been waiting for this one, and so have I.
And their opponents, accompanied by Xavier Woods, at a combined weight of 497 pounds, Big E and Kofi Kingston, the New Day.
When it comes to power, few superstars can match the strength of Big E.
And you can bet that power will be on display here tonight. Oh, the look on this guy's face tells me he's about to inflict some major pain. You better look out.
Here he is, one half of the Ascension Tag Team from Boston, Massachusetts, Connor.
Well, a team is only as strong as its weakest link, and time will tell who's the weak link here tonight.
Oh, yeah, nothing like an alliance of two great forces to become one indomitable tag team.
Well, anytime Connor's in the ring, you know you're going to get a serious show. So buckle up, everybody.
He's certainly showing us something new from his repertoire.
That's cool. I like new stuff.
Let's touch on Connor again. It's a tag team match, so the parts are sometimes greater than the whole. What can we expect here?
Tell us about Big E.
In a tag team, being a good partner is as important as anything else. How can he do his part tonight in this one?
As you know, we're talking about someone with a lot of talent. I'm not so sure I like the idea of it being showcased in a tag team. You got a talent like that, shine on his own.
Yeah. He's building himself an entourage.
You want attributes for Big E? It would take a lot less time to talk about what he doesn't have. Big E has incomparable strength, lightning quick speed, and for a man his size, a great physique, and a man who's comfortable fighting under any circumstances, and he's as tough as they come.
Yeah, Cole, I don't think we've ever seen someone in WWE like Big E. I mean, his power is unreal. And you said it, he is double tough. But when he starts running and makes contact with his opponent, you can feel that impact. Heck, you can hear it too. It sounds like a car wreck on the interstate.
This guy can go toe-to-toe with anybody.
King, he's obviously hoping to end it quickly.
Going to the top, high risk, nice move.
And a dangerous move. Michael, you spoke earlier about the almost endless list of abilities that Big E possesses. I can tell you from what I hear confidentially from WWE superstars in the locker room, Big E is considered one of the toughest opponents for that reason. How do you match up against him? I think we're only going to see that get worse for Big E's opponents. Victor finding a path of destruction currently.
We got a cover.
He's in that 6 feet tall, 290-pound range, and is just a monster. I mean, Big E's power and speed is a lethal combination, and I don't know if we've ever seen the likes of before. You know what that means? It means fans know that when Big E is making his way to the ring, things are bound to get nasty in there. I mean, real nasty.
Well, Big E taking control!
Yeah, this is about to be over because here comes...
now,
and he tags out. Looking for the quick cover is Kofi Kingston.
A quick reversal there by Victor.
Victor is getting ready here. Here comes Victor with an STO.
You gotta be kidding me. What a slam. What a ferocious slam.
Now that's how you do it. Can we face facts, please? They don't have just one opponent to worry about. They have two.
Boy, he was able to reverse it and get out of that.
He may be in the best physical condition I've ever seen him in.
A textbook reversal. Can he follow up?
He really needs to make a tag soon.
And Michael, this could be the opening he needs to pull ahead.
You know, I would have thought one of these guys would have shown signs of dominance at some point by now. That just hasn't really been the case.
Oh my, Kofi Kingston is in position.
And there's a dramatic rescue there. That could have been bad. He knows where he is right now.
How will these guys do with absorbing the punishment they're about to receive out here?
He gets out of trouble there.
Obvious action outside the ring. Real dangerous out here.
And the action could not be contained inside that ring.
He's got to be vigilant about not taking any more damage to the neck. Few superstars are as dominant as this guy.
Oh, what a counter.
Victor with nowhere to go. He started this match in great health, but now it seems fatigue has set in.
And at this point, his opponent definitely has that finisher well scouted. Going for it a third time might be a mistake.
Yeah, you know, I'm thinking it might be a good time for him to switch up his game plan. Whatever he's been doing just isn't working right now. Speed is incredible. He was a top NCAA football player at the University of Iowa and a powerlifter. Big E's an athlete. It's simple. When you're the size of Big E, everyone in the audience and in the locker room knows what you've come to do. Remember, they don't call it big for nothing.
He may get the three count right there.
Gonna be close.
This thing turns around here, this tag team match is all but over.
And Michael, given how evenly fought this has been up until now, this might be a pivotal.
Here we go for the win.
Think they got him.
What a reversal.
repertoire with that move. He may be in the best physical condition I've ever seen him in. Oh no, here we go. Big E sees it. He's going for the pin. This could be it.
I think he's got it.
History. What a win.
Here are your winners, Big E and Kofi Kingston, the New Day.
You want to talk about a tag team war? We most definitely witnessed just that. This was from bell to bell, a clinic in tag team wrestling. Kudos to everyone.
I love tag team matches, and that was one of the best I've seen in a while.
That was all about one competitor's refusal to lose. When you see that, you have no choice but to respect it.
You're going to be hard-pressed to find action like what we just saw anywhere else, but right here on Raw. What's this all about?
You know, talking it out makes me sick.
This could honestly be about a few things. Let's find out.
Yeah, let the cat out of the bag.
Just a bully.
Not exactly likable. Poking the bear. couldn't have said it better myself.
Now that's how you address an issue in the WWE.
And if that's any indication, we're in for one epic night. We'll see if the next match can equal that last one. Sit tight for singles action coming up next.